Hello, learners. It's time for class, and it is your favorite TV channel, Elimu TV, where you watch and learn. This is our history class, the third lesson on transport. And as always, it is your tutor, Rajab Muchira. Now, before we get today's class, can we get someone who can remind us of what we looked at the previous lesson? Very good. We looked at traditional forms of transport, and we did say we had human porterage, we had animal transport, we also had water transport. But for today's class, we'll get to modern means of transport. By the end of the lesson, what do we expect as learners? Can we get to state advantages of road transport? And also, can we get to identify challenges facing road transport today? Let us hit the road running. What is road transport, right? So this is transport mostly that involves on earth, right? On the roads, from the word road, or we can use the layman's language, yeah? So modern transport has developed largely, right? And we have got different types of roads. So, but the first ever road that was developed is the Roman roads. What are these Roman roads? From our image there, you can see an image of a Roman road there, right? And without going to the characteristics first, we can just get to name some of the characteristics we can see, right? What can we see in our image? Good. We can see that road is straight, right? Now that brings us to the first characteristic of the Roman roads. Now they were always constructed straight, and these roads were raised high above the ground to avoid flooding, right? So now meaning they were ditches, right? Now the ditches is where water could run. Now the roads were raised above the ground. These always prevented flooding, and also they were well drained on both sides. And as I've said, these roads were well built, had well built ditches. If you can see our first image, at the far end of the edge of the road, there's a ditch. Now that's the place where water could run. This prevented flooding. And these Roman roads, they were the first roads to ever have been established or built. And they were built by the Roman soldiers during the rise and development of the Roman emperor. And you get to look at another type of road, which is called the macadam roads. What are these macadam roads? First, they were developed, or they were invented, or they were built by one person we call John Macadam, from its word, macadam roads. And John Macadam devised a faster but a cheaper way of constructing these roads. Now, if you can see an image there of the macadam roads, those roads, they are smooth. That is one advantage of the modern road, right? Or we can call them the macadam road, right? It is a tarmac road. Now, it is always smooth. That is the road we always see. Those are the roads we use today in the modern world today. We call them the macadam road. Now, what are some of those characteristics of the macadam roads? One is that they were straight. Now, their characteristic of being straight, it reduced accidents on the roads, and also they had a smooth surface. Hence, the motoring surface was comfortable. From the images there, we can get to see we have the macadam roads, and they're very straight and smooth. Those are the macadam roads. Sorry for confusing the images. So we have the Roman roads, as you can see there very, very well. We have the macadam roads that we have already talked about. We have the images of the macadam roads. Now let us get to advantages of road transport. How is it advantageous today? One, it is one of the cheapest form of transport over short distance. For example, if you want to move from point A to point B using a vehicle on road transport, you can take the shortest time possible if that is there is no traffic jam. And also, it is faster compared to water and rail transport. It is fast. For example, a vehicle can run at 80 kilometers per hour, right? So within an hour, it can get to cover 80 kilometers. That you can't compare that with water transport or rail transport. And finally, it can be used by many means. In that case, we mean it can be used by human and animal transport also. We people, we pass on the roads. If you're using animal transport, you use the roads. So it can be used by many means. Having said that, we have other disadvantages of road transport. For example, accidents are high on roads. For example, in last year, Kenya recorded 1,287 deaths on the roads. Those are the rate that were recorded. Now, as you can see, it has caused high road accidents, and also there is traffic congestion leading to jams. Look at major towns, for example, Nairobi. Look at Mombasa. In the morning hours, there is traffic jam. In the evening hours, there is traffic jam. Road transport has led to congestion leading to jams, and also exhaust fumes. Motor vehicles cause air pollution. Now that they use diesel, most of these heavy trucks, right, they get to use diesel. Now, if they're using diesel, that has promoted also, or it has led to air pollution. And now for your assignment, can we get to test if we understood the subtopic correctly? One, who was the architecture who designed the macadam roads? Who designed the macadam roads? And also, what are some of the impacts of road transport? Can we get to refer to evolving world? That is always our reference material, evolving world, history, and government. And as always, learners, we have your favorite station where you watch and learn. Watch more lessons via Facebook in Elimu TV. On Twitter, you can follow us at Elimu_Kenya, or you can text us via our SMS 22518. Thank you.